Hi, my name is Maddie and I'm an instructor with Wordfence. Today we're going to take a look at the blocking options in the Wordfence firewall so you can quickly block or unblock visitors on your site. First, let's navigate to the Wordfence firewall page. Here, let's click the blocking tab at the top. On the blocking page, we notice the current blocks for your site section at the bottom of the page. Here, you will see any blocks you've input manually in this firewall blocking section, as well as login-related blocks, blocks you've made from the live traffic page, and others. Keep in mind that not all blocks made by the Wordfence plugin will appear here, and if you are not seeing a block here, it is also possible the block has been removed due to the block time expiring. Notice in the current block section, we have a few users who were locked out while trying to log in and while trying to use the password reset option on the login form. If you were to have a customer write in and say they were blocked by Wordfence while trying to log in or access their account, this is a section you would look to unblock them. First, you can look to see which username or email they were using when they got locked out, or alternatively, you can reference their IP address to confirm the user you need to consider unblocking. When you're ready to unblock someone, you can select the block with the checkbox and then click Unblock. If you do not see a block here and the user is seeing a Wordfence block page, you might consider checking their IP address in live traffic using the advanced filters. To do that, let's navigate over to Tools and then to Live Traffic. Make sure you check the Show Advanced Filters options and then select the IP option from the filter dropdown. In the field that appears to the right, you can copy and paste the IP that you want to find the traffic for and press enter. For more tips and information on how to use live traffic, you can view the dedicated video in our description. Now let's take a look at how to make a new block in the event there is a persistent IP or range of IPs that are hitting the site and we want to limit their access. Let's navigate to the blocking page by going to the firewall section and then the blocking tab. First, let's click the IP address option in the block type section. Here, we need to enter an IP address to block and a block reason. One thing to note is that the block reason here is a required field, so be sure to enter a reason for the block, and then you can click the Block This IP Address button to save the changes. Blocks that you enter here on the firewall blocking page are permanent blocks. We recommend checking back here from time to time to see if there has been recent activity on these blocks, which you can see via the last attempt and block count columns, and then decide if you need to keep that block there long term. Overall, we typically recommend limiting the number of permanent blocks you input here as attackers' IPs change frequently. If you're interested in the middle option here, country blocking, which is a premium feature, we have a video linked in our description that walks you through the different options to set that up. Now we can take a look at custom pattern blocks. This option gives us the ability to block via an IP address range, hostname, browser user agent, or referrer. Again, we see the block reason field here, which is also a required field. First, we can enter a block directive in one of the fields based on the examples we see in each field, and then enter a block reason and save the block. If you want to block a range, as we see in this field, you can enter that like so. After we input a block reason, we can then click Block Visitors Matching This Pattern. We can now see the block entered in our current block section with the range and block reason. If you're unsure of the information necessary to input into the block fields, such as the IP, user agent, or hostname, and you know that the malicious traffic has recently hit your site, you can navigate to the Live Traffic page and expand the relevant traffic hits in order to get the necessary information to populate the block via the blocking page. You also have the option to block an IP directly from live traffic, which will then populate a new entry in the current block section of the firewall blocking page that we were just on. The block time for blocks made via the block IP button in live traffic can be configured in the rate limiting section. To configure the block time, let's navigate to the All Options page and expand the rate limiting section. Here we see the option, how long is an IP address blocked when it breaks a rule, which is by default set to 5 minutes, and you can increase that value here if necessary. increasing this block time can be helpful if you're manually blocking IPs in live traffic frequently and need more time to monitor the activity. That is how to block or unblock IPs in Wordfence. Thanks for watching, and we look forward to securing your WordPress website.